Billy the Gums. Humbug and Joey. Isn't she cute? Felicity. They want me to feed them. Let's see. What should we do? Only two biggies. You better get more from the stash. Through the old box, with the firelight in position. Open the new box and look at the shrinkflation. But they don't care because these biscuits were grown from wheat, and the wheat came from places where they're not allowed to be anymore because someone will shoot them. And now that Billy's had his drink, he hasn't been fed a treat feeding the bread today. So now he's come over to have his little bit of bread. Isn't it great the way he can work his hands? Hey? That's because he started. As a bread fed Joey. Just like Humbug's little boy. Isn't that right? Hey, isn't that right? Yeah, Humbug's Joey. The bread-fed little boy. Yes, that's how it works. Isn't it, old mate? Hey? Yeah, absolutely. How about you have a bit more? That's a boy. And we'll give Felicity a little bit of the extra because she's really getting old. See that white fur on the muzzle? That's because she's older than 10 years. She's the ranking queen doe swamp wallaby in the clearing. She has a daughter and a grandson getting around lately. Humbug. I think this is her second Joey, and her first Joey is a buck, and he's also still alive, which is really quite rare. You don't often get a marsupial doe raising their first Joey to be old enough to finish weaning. Hey, do we? We're doing very well here, aren't we? Hey? See how he's covering his balls with his claws? Yeah, that's what you call a sign of submission. It's because he treats me as his family's pet tame human. More or less almost like his grandfather. Isn't that right, hey? And swamp wallabies were eaten out of my hand for 18 years before the first kangaroo ate bread. As weird as that is. I think what was going on was the kangaroos thought I was a swamp wallaby totemic human. Is that what was going on, Billy? Something like that. See? Intergenerational human interaction lessons. I think it's bloody great. But don't you try this shit at home. I've been living here for 34 years. All of these people regard me as their family's pet tame human. If you go out there into the forest and you try and approach wild, unfenced marsupials who don't know you and don't know that you've been well behaved for 30 years, they're probably going to give you a colostomy with their toenail while they hold you by the shoulders and bite your jugular vein right through. Because it's a thing they can do if they think you need it. If they think that's what you deserve. But you're not an arsehole. You have nothing to fear from a kangaroo court. Because they're actually quite good judges of character. I find, in my experience and observation, Warbles on at the YouTube. Ciao.